초콜릿은 달콤해 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 오렌지는 상큼해 상큼해 상큼해.
Hi everyone, this is Anna and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to talk about the part 2 of the video that I uploaded here on my channel. And I'm very happy to have you here, guys. Thank you for subscribing. But before we dive in, if you're new here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring that notification bell so you never miss out on our exciting vlogs and adventures, and especially the information about the immigration and the spousal visa journey. Now, let me give you a sneak peek of this vlog. We will discuss the part 2 of the video entitled CR1 Visa Approved in Just 10 Minutes. In part 1 of this video, someone commented about me speaking English that I am trying to be slang. According to her, oh my goodness, trying to be slang? Magtatagalog na lang kasi. I'm so sorry for you that my English is not that good, because I'm Bisaya, that's why I'm trying to speak English here, so the Tagalog can understand me, because I don't want to speak Tagalog on my videos because I am not that good too. But thank you for that comment, I appreciate that, so I can improve more. Yeah, actually guys, when you say slang, it means a type of language that consists of words and phrases that are regarded as very informal. I have never been using slang words in my videos because I am trying to be formal here. I understand what she's trying to say. She's trying to say that I am trying to have an accent, and I understand that. To you, it's okay. You're trying to say that I am trying to have an accent here. Yeah, which is true. Okay, let's proceed to our topic. So now, how did I get my CR1 visa approved in just 10 minutes? Let's find out. Okay, my visa interview was on the 10th of July 2023 at 7 a.m. I stayed in a City Garden Manila hotel, where the U.S. Embassy is just 12 minutes away on foot. Pwede na siyang lakawin in Tagalog. Pwede na kayong maglakad pa itong U.S. Embassy kasi malapit lang. On that day, we went to the embassy at 6:30 a.m. with my aunt. I asked my aunt to go with me. Aside from being a first timer going to Manila, I need someone outside the embassy to keep my gadgets, such as phones and laptop, because it is not allowed to bring gadgets inside the U.S. embassy. We arrived there like 6:42 a.m. There are lots of people already. There were two lines of the people there who have different visas. The left line is for the petition visas like mine, the CR1 or spousal visa. And the right line is for the working and tourist visa. When the security guard said that it is fine to go inside, even my schedule is at 7 a.m. So I went to the next line, and you need to prepare your passport and DS-260 form. They will put a sticker on the back of your passport to tell which set you will be. I was set A. So when I go inside, after they scanned me for security purposes, and my things, you know, just like in the airport when you're going through, I proceed to sit A and sit there and wait for the next instruction. Next instruction was checking all of my civil documents. They interviewed me for personal information and my husband's information too. Make sure that you bring all of the documents that you uploaded in your CEAC or SHOC or CEAC, the portal there that you made. After that, I proceed to the next line, which is the fingerprinting or the fingerprint scanning. All of the Filipino interviewers were so kind, so you will not be nervous on the way. Next to that is waiting for the consul to open their windows. When it is already opened, you will wait for your name to be called and pay attention because sometimes their voice is so slow and the surroundings is very noisy. When they called my name, they said, "Anari Tuiko, window 10. You have to listen carefully so you will know which window you're going to, because they will not call you again once they call your name. And if you're not paying attention, you have to wait for all the applicants to finish and then you will be called again." Yeah. And also guys, the consul will the one call you, and you have to listen carefully because their accent is a bit different than us. My interviewer was a male. He looked so strict because he didn't smile at me at first, and every time he asked me questions, he sounds like confused and thinking that my information is correct or not. The only documents he asked me is the passport and the marriage license from Utah, because he asked me where we got married. So I said we got married online. That is why he asked for that certificate. Other questions he asked me are, when was the last time my husband visited to the Philippines, and when was the first time? I answered that you have to be confident when you answer the question. And then another question, how many people live in my husband's house? So yeah, he asked me only 5 questions and he gave me the paper about domestic violence. I forgot, it's the packet. They said it's the packet. It is called a packet, and it's all about the domestic violence. Once they give you that paper, it means you are already approved. And then he returned a marriage certificate from Utah and keep my passport. And guys, if they don't return your passport, it also means that you got approved. They will return the passport in 2 weeks in the delivery address that you provided online. Make sure you put the correct address so your passport will be safe going back to you. And before I end this topic, I'm gonna answer some questions that they were asking in the previous video here on my channel. Remember, the title is CR1 Visa Interview Approved in Just 10 Minutes, plus the questions asked and the tips. Just watch this video again if you want. So there are comments that I haven't answered regarding the video. And okay, let's find out. And let's answer all of these comments. So there is from Juan Dayap Dapan 8713. Thank you for this. Me waiting for the approvals and visa. Good luck for you, sis. Just pray and believe. And next, the next comment that I haven't answered, where is it? Okay, from user Ho1FX4VG6B. Sis, just wanna ask, do you report your marriage to the consulate general para magkaroon po ng record sa PSA? Hinanapan ka pa ba ng AOM, advisory on marriage from PSA? At yung passport mo ba nag-change status ka pa po? Sana masagot po kasi kinsal kami sa Australia. Wala kami record sa PSA. Okay, for this question, yeah, we reported our marriage to the consulate general. That's why we have the PSA marriage certificate. And it is one of the requirements in processing the spousal visa. And for reporting the visa, sis, we didn't submit an AOM or advisory on marriage sa pag-report ng marriage sa general consulate. Wala pong AOM na hinahanap. And sa passport ko, hindi ako nag-change status sa passport ko. I am here already in the USA and it's still single and it's in my maiden name. Yeah, it's up to you if you want to change your status and your name on your passport before processing the visa. I think it will be a lot easier if you change your status and the last name. Because in my case, I don't have time to change my status and my name on my passport. That's why I didn't change it. Yeah. And okay, for you have to report your marriage in the PSA. So you can have a PSA marriage certificate that is required in the processing of visa. That's all for this video, and I hope that it really helps you guys on your spousal visa journey.